Live from Hazard, Kentucky, this is Jammin' John's Wrestling News. Here's your news for Thursday, July 18th, 2019. CM Punk, who did an autograph signing for Pro Wrestling Tees last year during All In Weekend, will be appearing at Starrcast III during All Out Weekend in Chicago. Starrcast is run by Conrad Thompson and isn't officially part of AEW, according to Thompson. So there you have it, folks. CM Punk will be at Starrcast III. The WWE announced the following today. WWE is proud to announce the Smackville special event featuring a triple threat match for the WWE Championship and streaming live from Nashville, Tennessee, exclusively on the award-winning WWE Network on Saturday, July 27th. The explosive in-ring action will include a main event triple threat match for the WWE Championship in which Kofi Kingston will be challenged by Dolph Ziggler and Samoa Joe. In addition, newly crowned Intercontinental Champion Shinsuke Nakamura will go head-to-head with former title holder Finn Balor in a rematch from WWE Extreme Rules. The evening will also feature a special musical performance by Elias. Don't miss Smackville, streaming live from Music City, USA on Saturday, July 27th at 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 6 p.m. Pacific Time, exclusively on WWE Network. Sasha Banks has been pulled from advertising for this Monday's Raw reunion show. Here is an updated list of legends that are scheduled for the event. Alundra Blaze, Booker T, Christian, Devon Dudley, D-Generation X, Triple H, Shawn Michaels, Shawn X-Pac Waltman, and Road Dogg Jesse James, Eric Bischoff, Gerald Briscoe, Hulk Hogan, Hurricane Helms, Jerry Lawler, Jimmy Hart, Kelly Kelly, Kevin Nash, Kurt Angle, Lillian Garcia, Mark Henry, Melina, Mick Foley, Pat Patterson, Ric Flair, Rikishi, Ron Simmons, Santino Marella, Scott Hall, Sergeant Slaughter, Shawn Michaels, Sid Vicious, Steve Austin, Ted DiBiase Sr., The Boogeyman, and The Godfather. And speaking of Shawn Michaels, he announced on Twitter that in addition to the Raw reunion, he will also be appearing on next week's SmackDown Live. Shawn Michaels tweeted, "I've had a lot of fun times on Monday Night Raw, but I'm not just coming to the Raw reunion to see some friends. Old HBK is going to be doing commentary this Tuesday on SmackDown Live." Also staying on the topic of Shawn Michaels, he was also shown in a trailer for the parody film Avengers for Justice, Farce Wars. Sounds like a very promising movie. Dave Meltzer of F4WOnline.com provided some notes regarding WWE SmackDown's move to Fox on October 4th. Here was Meltzer's notes. SmackDown will be airing 51 weeks a year on Fox, with the show be preempted for the World Series. It's possible the show could move to Fox Sports 1 for that 1 week. A one-hour launch show is being scheduled for late September to introduce casual Fox viewers to the WWE product. There is talk about putting NXT on Fox Sports, which would possibly lead to NXT going head-to-head with AEW on Wednesday nights. Regarding the rumored talk show, Meltzer noted that this is not a done deal yet, but the weekly talk show on Fox Sports 1 is a done deal, as has already been announced with Renee Young as the host. There are various methods that will likely be used to promote the Fox debut, including wrestlers driving a moving truck to various cities and the usage of a digital primer to teach viewers the insider terms. Several big surprises are being talked about for the debut on Fox. WrestlingNews.co is reporting that Vince McMahon is high on Drake Maverick right now. The minute-by-minute numbers from Nielsen Media Research were said to be strong for the R-Truth and Maverick segments. A source within WWE said, "Vince loves everything he's doing because Drake is funny and he's not afraid to be the butt of the joke, and Vince will get behind someone like him. He's also not a complainer." In addition to the storyline of R-Truth, Maverick is continuing to make appearances on 205 Live. While Eric Bischoff was not in attendance for Raw or SmackDown this week, it's believed that Bischoff started his new job with WWE on Wednesday. While Bischoff is said to be in charge of the brand, Dave Meltzer of F4WOnline.com noted that, "Right now, those in creative were told that he will most likely not be involved with the creative process, and that it looks like his job will be to interface with all the departments in the company, as well as with Fox." Bischoff noted during his latest podcast recording on Tuesday night that he'll be at the television tapings next week. Bischoff said, "Well, I'm actually watching SmackDown as we speak. I'm boning up, I'm doing my research and getting familiar. I'm going into the office tomorrow. I'm kind of getting oriented and starting the process and kicking it off Monday and Tuesday next week. Thanks to eWrestlingNews.com for the quote. And finally, here on Jammin' John's Wrestling News, usually this is the part of the show where I plug my Patreon so that you guys can go check it out and hopefully subscribe to it. But today, I'm deciding to leave that out because I would like to talk about something very dear to me. For those of you who don't know, I'm a big fan of anime. I've loved anime ever since I was 3 or 4 years old. And last night, I found some horrifying news out through a notification on my phone. There was a tragedy that occurred with Kyoto Animation today. For those who do not know, a 41-year-old male carried out an arson attack on Kyoto Animation Studio 1 in Kyoto, Japan, which completely devastated the studio. As of this reporting, 33 people are dead, 36 others are injured, over 70 plus was in the building as the arson attack happened. Kyoto Animation is a huge animation studio in Japan that has produced some very well-known anime. The examples include K-On!, Lucky Star, the film A Silent Voice, and my personal favorite, The Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya. Anime is not only an art form, but it is also a way for many awesome people to escape from the real world's problems. It helps people's anxieties and takes the weights of stress off their shoulders. I honestly don't know why someone would do something so revolting. However, if it's one thing I do know about otakus, it's that they kick ass. Currently, there is a GoFundMe to help get Kyoto Animation back on its feet, and as of this reporting, over $1 million has been raised in less than 24 hours for Kyoto Animation. And after hearing that, there's just no words to explain how much love and how much respect otakus have for Kyoto Animation. After all these years of giving us these amazing storylines with creative characters, it's the best way that we could pay it forward and give it back to them during this very hard time. If you would like to make a donation and help out Kyoto Animation during the darkest time ever in the industry of Japanese animation, you can go to gofundme.com/help-kyoani-heal. Once again, that is gofundme.com/help-kyoani-heal. Once again, gofundme.com/help-kyoani-heal. And all I want to say right now is, Kyoto Animation, my love goes out to you during this very dark time. So once again, if you'd like to donate and help out Kyoto Animation, you can go to gofundme.com/help-kyoani-heal. It would be greatly appreciated. That is your news for Thursday, July 18th, 2019. Check back here tomorrow for another Jammin' John's Wrestling News Flash Briefing on Amazon Alexa devices, Spotify, YouTube, Stitcher, and iTunes. Follow me on Twitter at John Caldwell, JonColwell. Follow me on Instagram, The Jammin' John. If you'd like to sponsor Jammin' John's Wrestling News or your wrestling promotion, want to get your next big event out, you can email me, jzcaldwell@gmail.com. That's jzcaldwell@gmail.com. Big shout out to Ryan Hurdle and Tony Nelson for subscribing to my Patreon. You too can subscribe to me by going to patreon.com/jammin'john. I have free packages on there ranging from $3 to $7. Not a whole lot of money. I would really appreciate it if you supported me a little bit financially. And the results of the latest special subscriber poll will be coming up tomorrow. Once again, that is patreon.com/jammin'john if you'd like to help me out a little bit financially. This is Jammin' John saying thanks. Goodbye, and I'll see you tomorrow.